Kama mara tano kwa mwezi ni is it too much guys? Channel. My name is Beth and Mr. Murungi is not around. Thank you so much guys for joining us today. So today we have a guest. Before we go further, let me introduce our guest. Let her introduce herself, then we continue from there.
Hey everyone, my name is Gladys Ndunda. Mm-hmm. I'm Beth's friend. We've been friends since campus.
Yes.
So yeah, today we decided to see what we can do together. So I'm excited for today's episode. I hope it's going to be amazing.
Yes, yeah. Kindly comment down below what you think about this episode because it's going to be fire. So make sure you stick around, subscribe if you've not yet subscribed, and give this video a thumbs up. So on today's video with Gladys, we are going to do about her expectations of marriage because she's not yet married. We're single. What about single wenje?
Oh, please, guys. Come on, maze. I am ready.
Comment up on one.
Niko tayari, kila kitu iko in order.
Imagine. Yule mboy yote ati ako single.
Imagine, si poa.
So, she's not married and I've been married for almost four years. This is the fourth year. So, at least I have some experience to kidogo.
Yeah.
So, maybe she'll tell us her expectations of marriage and I'll be telling her.
Reality.
So if you're there, yeah, unaweza kuuliza any question, just comment down below. Mm-hmm. Now we'll surely answer your question. So are you ready?
I think so. Yeah, I'm ready. Ready. So me, as I've said,
your first experience.
Me number one, I am ready for marriage. Mm-hmm. Like mimi niko na namba ya watu wa super metro.
Mm-hmm.
Basi ngapi? Mbili ziende village zichukue villagers wakuje harusi. Anyway. Mm-hmm. So me, honestly, to be honest, my being single,
mm-hmm.
Of course there are things that natamaningi like saizi ninge kwa na partner,
mm-hmm.
You know. So my first expectation is mm-hmm. that sijui, I think I'm gonna start on a very high note. Mm-hmm. I think for me, to be honest, my first expectation is that my husband will provide 100%.
100%.
Yeah.
So we are in 21st century.
Yes,
my dear.
Mm-hmm.
And you're working, yeah. Right? And your mm-hmm. husband is working. So, okay, he will provide, but not 100%.
Mm-hmm.
Because you are his helper.
Yeah.
A helper is supposed to help.
Uh-huh.
So, vitu kama, unaona hizi bills, big bills. Mm-hmm. Tuzite big bills.
Yes.
Rent, fuel in cars, education. Hizo ni zake, 100%.
Uh-huh.
So to vitu kama food maybe,
uh-huh.
Shopping mlifanya lakini una need kununua kanyama.
That's what I can buy, that's what I can do.
Hizo ndio unasaidia.
Oh, is that true? Yeah. I'm ready guys. If I'm only buying meat, jamani, wapenzi watazamaji. If I'm only buying nyama and nyanya, I'm ready.
Hizo ndio
unasaidia. Guys, you people, ebu comment down below. But if you're single, I'm for real. Mm. Kama tu unataka nikubei nyama, no problem. As long as you provide it.
Like it has to say me at him, share 50-50.
Hey? 50-50 where?
At rent ni 50,000 won at 25.
See, nikai peke yangu. See, like, nikai tu peke yangu ni jivipi kila 200%.
So, unamsaidia hizo nyanya, vitungu, kakuku, you know, such things.
Yeah, so like, in short, like, if he does, like, for example, like, akifanya the monthly shopping, yeah? Mm-hmm. And then katikati ya mwezi, of course, they cannot last you throughout the whole month.
Throughout the whole month.
Kitu, like, kitu maybe ishe, tuseme kitu kama nini.
Kama
chumvi, guys.
Kama chumvi. Utamudisha ati.
$50 jamani nikanunua ya stupid.
Exactly.
Okay.
So una top up.
Okay.
Maybe leo mmejisikia kula something. Si lazima ushinde umempigia babe. Nataka kula something. We just buy.
Yeah, of course. Mm-hmm. So let me ask. So is it like
now you take care of yourself for him? Yeah.
Hello. Yeah. Hello. Yes. Yeah, and you give me your credit card so that I can take care of myself.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So is it like a conversation that you need to have mm-hmm. before marriage, am I?
Yes. It is very, very important.
How do you start? Like, how do you...
Very important.
Sasa, mimi as a woman, how do I start that conversation to this, someone that I'm dating?
Let me tell you, before we got married, yeah. my husband, yeah. tulikuwa na issue na finances. Okay. Sana, sana, sana. Uh-huh. Because me, I knew my money is my money, his money is our money. Yes. Yo. And you're supposed to, you know. Uh-huh. So, we had to sit down and agree. So, for us, right now, the way we are handling finances,
yeah.
tuna put in... Together.
Okay.
Yes. So finances zetu ziko open. Hakuna tu ulienda ukapata 100,000 mimi nikapata 50 alafu tumeficha. So we are open.
Yeah.
So kuna zile zenye tunaweka hizi za long term savings. Hizi zile savings za hapa kule
yeah.
nini hii nataka hii nataka hii hizo. Alafu hii ni ya matumizi ya nyumba.
Yes.
Alafu this is your allowance. This is my allowance.
Oh, anakupa allowance after allowance.
Yes.
Bro,
wife allowance.
Hello.
Hello.
Children and wife allowance.
Please.
Very important.
Nampatia allowance yangu.
So now when you get money, like you bring it to the table yote.
Yes.
Ukishatoa tithe.
Yes. So saizi tunatoanga tithe pamoja.
No way.
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Si tithe unafaa kutoa peke yako. Like if you're earning 100k, unatuma 10k and then now you bring 90k.
Ama sasa kama I'm earning 100k na yeye ana 100k, si tithe tu bado ni same ni 20k.
Now, what if you don't have the same spiritual parents? Ama, that's also another thing in marriage.
Yeah, that's another thing.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Okay.
But finances, zinafazi kuwe open. Zinafazi kuwe open. Because sisi tulikuwa na hiyo issue sana, 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 sana.
Because when you were dating. Yeah. But babe, when you were dating, anashika pesa yako, eh?
So we had to sit down and agree.
Yes.
Before getting into marriage. Because yeah. ingekuwa a bigger issue. So sahi hatuna issue ya, yani ya finances.
Okay.
We don't argue about finances. So yeah. before you get into marriage, you have to agree.
Mm-hmm.
This is what I'll do. This is what you'll do. Ama, let's bring our finances together. Now we have a kid. Ama, yes. we are going to have children.
Yes.
So lazima tuwapangie life yao.
Of course. Yes. Yeah.
So lazima tukuwe na long term savings. Tukuwe na. Yani you have to channel your money
yeah.
in very important things.
Yeah.
Si society. Unajua sahi nikisema pesa ni yangu.
Yeah.
Nitakuwa selfish enough and I'll do my own things. Mm. Na watoto wanafaa kusoma. Wanafaa yeah. kuvaa vizuri. We need to eat well. So you have to agree on yeah. that matter.
Well, guys.
But as long as you're dating your money, it's your money.
As long as we are dating.
Yes.
Underline.
As long as you're dating.
Yeah. Oh my
keep
God.
Keep your money for yourself.
I keep my money for myself.
Yes.
As long as we are dating.
Yes.
Because that's such a... I think for me...
But I've in been, marriage, yes. don't take responsibilities ya mwanaume. Don't... Just be feminine. Usiitake kuati... Ai, si hata mimi nafanya kazi. Tugawane nusu nusu rent, alipe nusu.
Ah, iwezekani?
No,
it can't work. Ai, mi,
let him be a man.
Mimi hata nikipata tu mwanaume aniambie kama mimi kaa
kwa nyumbani.
By the way, to be honest, let me tell you, I'm not saying that yao mama wanawake, like I'm not the kind of a woman mwenyati. I'm not a corporate woman mwenyati. I want ati naamka asubuhi natengeneza chai naenda job. Guys, I don't want that. At 8 to 5.
You want to enjoy.
I can't. Mimi hata naweza pata mtu ananiambia kaa home. Me, I'll be a happy housewife. Right. Housewife kudanganyi. Because I know being a housewife, of course. I'll be running businesses here yes. and there, but there's no way me honestly stuck with employer. Like it's something that I constantly say even to my friends. Like at when I'm younger, like me by the time like I'm saying I do, I don't want ni kwenda mkasubuhi kwenda kujibu.
Kwenda job.
A certain boss. I don't want. Like I want to be a fully committed wife, a mother.
Like right now, since I got pregnant, sijakuwa nikienda kazi, so I've been home. So he has been fully providing.
Yes.
So akianza ku complain, unaona hapo kuna problem.
Oh yeah, so now you have to now get up after gigs.
Yes. But as long as my husband anajua ndio provider,
yeah,
I'm okay. I'm taking care of the house.
So let me ask.
The baby?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So at what point, okay, because mimi nakwanga like, if we are starting off marriage, yeah, of course, maybe we are struggling kidogo, but ikifika point enye, you can actually take care of the family 100%.
Take care.
See, like, they are supposed to take care.
Yes.
Like, inafaa kufika point, sasa niambie, ah, baby, baby girl.
Relax.
Sasa pesa yako, fanya kile unataka. Fanya kile unataka. I will take
it out there by the way if right. you are able.
If you're able, just do that for her.
Just do that for
because her. At the end of the day, if you've married like a woman when you unajua, of course she's not selfish. At the end of the day, even if she gets her money, there's no way stima itaisha na uko job akupigia simu kwa beti nataka tokens. There's no way. Okay, I think okay, sawa. But anyway, so pesa ni yetu sisi wote.
Eh, you agree
when we married?
Yes, you agree.
Yes.
So but if you can fully provide,
I'll be happy. Evolve, please provide.
Please provide. We do a lot of things.
Please provide.
Current pregnancy for 9 months. Taking care of the house. Taking care of the kids.
And taking please care provide. Of you, big baby.
Yes, please take care of us.
Oh my God.
Just
okay.
Go and work.
Okay, another expectation that I have.
Mm-hmm.
I expect that. Mm-hmm. That we will be doing it like every day.
let me tell you
by the way why I'm saying that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I must say, being single is not funny.
Mm-hmm.
And especially, you know, when you're married, like umepeana kwa church mbele ya parents and everybody.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm saying that unasikanga wanawake wa complain akisema ati wewe unasemanga tu hivyo utaingia ndio utajua. How is it like, is it possible like to have, you know, it every day?
It is very possible.
Hallelujah, shagada.
It is very possible. Let me tell you one thing.
Mm-hmm.
I think it depends with the kind of marriage and the kind of partner that you have.
Okay.
Because my marriage, I have a good husband.
Amen.
And I have a sweet marriage.
Ooh.
So hata ukimwangalia tu vya kenda asubuhi na sketo siku ni kwa dress kidogo ni kuchangamsha,
you know,
alafu ukienda because relationship yenu si ati ile boring, you know, relationships you have to be creative.
Yeah,
I'll show you after the video.
Yeah,
we have things to spice up.
You have to tell you in the comment section. I will come and tell you what she showed me. Me, I don't keep secrets.
Yes. You have to spice up your marriage.
Okay.
If you don't spice up your marriage, you know, boring, unapata. Mm-hmm. You do it after 2 weeks. After
2 weeks. That's a lot.
Then go explore. You know, exploring and understanding. Like my husband really tries a lot. Learn what I love, your sector, sasa.
Yes.
How to treat me that sector. So he knows.
Yes.
He knows nikifanya hivi, anapenda. Nisipofanya hivi, hapendi.
Okay.
So at least ina make pia mini feel, I want it every time.
Can I ask,
Does
it change when you give birth?
Yes, it changes. But in a positive side. Because according to me, for us, it became Drisa and sweeter.
Ooh. I tap in Jesus' name.
And now after having a kid, we are exploring more. Because we don't have to have a boring marriage.
Yes.
You know, marriages are built by two people.
Of course.
So now most marriages no nagas na break after having kids, so you nini unabuild to me, then taking care of yourself as a woman.
Yeah.
Now, you know, after giving birth you have to take care of yourself. You have usianze ku smell usianze, you, because after giving birth kuna tu chafu mingi zinatoka.
Okay.
You change a lot.
Yeah.
So you really have to take care of yourself. If you don't take care of yourself unapata gata bwana ai
kidogo
ana boeka.
Yes.
But if you take care of yourself inakuwa but it is sweet.
It is sweeter.
We are enjoying it.
So kids don't change at
CG
what?
In fact it becomes better. My experience.
I think I also ninani huyu. I don't know who I was watching.
Mm-hmm.
She was saying that actually after she gave birth,
mm-hmm.
I think it is Akina Kajim.
Mm-hmm.
They were saying like after they gave birth.
Perfect.
Hey. Funny what happens. I want to know that science.
Imagine I don't know. I was asking my husband the other day. Giving birth. Tunabiago utapanuka.
Yeah.
My friend.
Mm? Heaven on earth.
Hey.
Mount Zion, guys.
It is sweeter. It is better.
Mm-hmm.
Yani, I don't know. Then my husband was there when I was giving birth. He was in the delivery room.
Oh, wow. You lucky babe.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Lucky girl.
I'm lucky. So he was there. He saw everything. Yani, he was there sweating.
Wow.
So I think then after there, he just appreciates me more. Yeah. It was a nice experience.
Yeah.
And
Zegs is sweeter after having kids. I think for most people who have not given birth, I think inakwanga like
kunakwanga na hiyo fear. Because hata me before I gave birth, yeah. Nikiwa tuna mimba, sangu anamuliza kai babe, na sasa niki change, utaniacha, utacheat, utafanya sijui nini. So nilikuwa scared.
I got you.
I got you. So it is sweeter. It is better.
It is sweeter.
It is better even okay. Before.
Amen. Mm. Even before. Mm. All right. Mm-hmm. Another expectation.
Uh-huh.
Okay. I don't know if I'm just being selfish or anything, mm-hmm. but I would honestly expect any free time that this man has. Like free time, I mean, ukitoka job, you're coming home. Mm-hmm. You're coming straight home.
Mm-hmm.
If you're having a night out mm-hmm. with your boys, mm-hmm. like I expect open communication.
Mm-hmm.
I expect say like ni kuenajua akwapi akwapi na nafanya nini. As in, I don't necessarily have to know what he's doing during the day, but just tell me in the morning naenda job.
Yeah.
Ukifika job, wewe ukitoka job saa 10 ama saa 3 ama saa
1,
niambie umetoka job. Alafu kama kwa barabara umepatana na maboys ni nini, text me, imagine niambie nitachelewa kufika home. Don't like communication. How is communication in marriage?
Communication, you have to agree.
Yeah.
You have to have an open, you know, when you have an open communication, an open marriage, yani, yeah. You don't, like me, si onagi need ya ku hide anything from my husband.
Okay.
You know, my husband anza kuja niambie, babe. Na kuna kadem nimekaona kanaka kama wewe karibu kanichanganye. Yani we just talk.
You give it a feel like
yes,
that.
You're free.
Me, I'll kill you. Don't you
karibu kanichanganye.
Okay, I'm joking. I won't kill you. We love.
Karibu kanichanganye kidogo. Like, yani, tunapiga story. We have open conversation. So, akitoka job, akitoka ameenda job. Babe, nimilifika poa niko lunch time. Yani, he just communicates.
Without me having to ask. Okay.
So, tokea job, like, right now, utaona tu watapiga.
What if, like, you have wale watu wenye tu, like, they don't communicate. Nasi ati yako na ubaya, nasi ati yako mali. Like, how do you bring out yes, your person to, like, communicate?
I hate to tell my husband because he's the person. Oh. Mkisha ongea subuhi, yanajua mko sawa. Yani, ni ule, alikuwa ule msewa. Si lazima keep on calling, texting. Mm. So I had to tell mimi napenda kiniambia at least babe sahi niko hivi nafanya hivi niko fit hivyo. So he had to learn and I learned to pole pole. So you have to talk. Any communication is the key in any marriage, in any relationship.
Yes.
You have to be open, you have to talk. How you're feeling, mwambie mimi na feel hivi na hivi na hivi na hivi. Ndio as juu uwezi assume tuseme nafaa ajue mimi na feel hivi.
Yes.
No, you can't assume. You have to communicate. You have to tell me napenda hivi na hivi na hivi na spend hivi na hivi na hivi. Then yeye akwambie. Okay. So you really have to communicate, have a serious sit down.
Wow.
Yes.
Hey, up kwa communication. Actually, now even knowing, like, especially if you now know the kind of a person that you have, and then you're imagining, mkianza communication on anikama maybe na msumbua, like,
you have.
Why are we talking about these things? Like, when you obviously get a job, where else can I go? See, I'm coming straight home. You know, like,
you have to sit down.
So niko
alafu unajua, as much as we are married, kila mtu ako na ile personal space yake.
There is personal space in marriage.
What I mean ni, kuna ile time ataniambia, shagri, mambia, ah, babe, boy, at a weekend, you can go out with your boys.
Oh.
Yani, usimfungie tena
of
sana.
Of course, yeah,
kila
yeah,
time ako na wewe.
Ah, mi am tuto.
Yani, ataniambia, unataka kwenda with the girls?
Go.
Mm. Yani, he's just open. If you feel, nataka ni kukujie, weto utanipigia simu, takukujia kwenye uko. Nataka kwenda, yani he's just free.
Yeah.
Eh, usikae tena ati hapana hizi end out na maboys, sizi end out na ma girls, no.
Ma girls bora end out na ma girls. There's no going out with the girls. I am the girls.
Wewe sasa.
Oh, mimi. Oh.
Okay. Wewe uwezi enda na ma girls ati na yeye enda na ma boys.
Okay.
But pia kienda lazima communication.
Ni vizuri ya communicate.
Sana to video calls ndio at least ukue. Unajua sisi na sisi tunatakaga evidence.
Yes. Kuna pastor alikuwa anasema if you want your wife to just trust you. If for example you have maybe a business trip and umeenda Angola. Why did I think of Angola? Surely, what is even Angola? Hey, chai, Angola.
Video call her. Show her your
video call her. mwambie baby this is my room kkkkkk at least that in ukifanya hivyo in like 3 years you not hata utakuwa na date start up on video call you text or mimi nimefika.
Yes,
okay, sawa. Another expectation about in-laws. To be honest, I honestly expect that even before we get married, there's already that boundary created na in-laws. So that, because of course we've had a lot of stories, but I do believe in God that I'll get good in-laws in Jesus' name. But it is what it is, and people are people, you know. If today I got a sister-in-law, of course nitamchunguza, nitaka kujua. Na si ati niko na, maybe for her ataona ni kama sister, you have come too much, you know. But so, how do you honestly deal with mini in-laws? Because me, honestly expect my space. I don't expect even my siblings. Like, I don't expect them to be coming in my house. At
every time.
So, I don't also expect the other parents. But unless he has kids that maybe he's taken care of. Unajua saizi. Our parents, most of people wanachangwa na parents. Wako quite young. So, unapata most of the responsibility now you have to take. Unaona. So, not unless, of course, you are taking care of your siblings already and you are staying with them. There's no problem. But at now we've gotten married. Tumehama kutoka from a bed sitter. Tumenda sasa kwa two bedroom. Wanasama hiyo room moja ina mtu hata amna watoto. Wajeni, I always expect some boundaries.
In-laws, kunafaa kuwa boundaries.
Yes.
Hata wakispend sana, yani wasikuja ati mtu amekuja kwa whole month.
Yeah. Eh? One month.
Surely.
Na kila room ni.
Hey.
Ni kasarani.
Yeah,
kila room ni kasarani, my friend. Don't stay for long.
Hey, hata wakuja kutembea,
yeah,
a few days, mtu anarudi kwake ama kwao.
Yeah.
Because in-laws ndio most marriages zenye mimi nimesikia, in-laws pia wanachangia sana ku separate marriages. Cause mtu atakuja, like maybe brother wangu atakuja, anaanza kusema huyu bwanako atakufanyia hivi, huyu atakufanyia hivi, kwa nini anakutreat hivyo?
Yes.
Na hivyo ndio nyinyi mnaishi, na wewe uone ubaya, so anaanza kukufeed vitu zenye hata hakuna.
Yeah,
by the way,
anaanza kukufungua to evil eyes, to macho tenye hata
hatukua. Even friends pia wanakuja siku moja, siku mbili, shup, mtu anarudi kwake. Hakuna ati kukaa ati sasa unakaa.
Let me tell you, I have a friend of mine. She's married. You cannot sleep in her house.
Na blame her.
If you want to see me, you come home early kwangu, unakuja kwangu mapema 6.
Unatoka mapema.
Train ya town ikitoka utoke nayo, like tuheshimiane.
Saa moja ikifika kula sapa
and leave.
Yes.
And now wende.
Imagine that's okay.
And that's okay. Guy, I love her for that. Hey. Like, I normally love na pikira. Oh yeah, sister. Tunapata mati patani. She's like, mmechelewa guys, saa hivi ni saa 7. Na unajua mimi na wewe tumanzangi story. So we plan again mpaka next
time. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Imagine hakuna.
And there's nothing wrong with that. I actually love her for that.
Marriage.
And it is good.
And this is very good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, another expectation. Okay. I don't know if it's because nimelelewa hivyo or me expect to have two homes. Ya Ushago na ya Nairobi.
Yeah. It's very important,
right?
Yeah.
Like I honestly expect hata kama utakuwa umejenga,
at least kuna
kama kile hata kama ni ya mabati. Imagine ina shida,
pekele hata kama ni mabati unalala kwa mama.
Sitaki kulala kwa mama yenu. Cuz don't do that.
Yes.
Jenga hata kama ni ya mabati. Hata kama ni one
or two homes.
Yes.
Chupia
I expect that.
Kenda home at least tuko na
kwenyu
ya kwetu, at least
like a
crib, at least pia una feel comfortable,
yeah, because it's still your home, because you are married,
because you do things. Imagine sasa
exactly
kwa madhaiglo tumelala huko.
Yeah, it will cause chaos.
That's a good expectation.
I think it's because my mom alijengewa kitambo, like sisi by the time I was waking up like this, me I found a home Ushago and in the city. So nilikuwa naona mom like anaenda Ushago, sio anaenda analima anarudi, and I think I kind of love that. The fact that so my mom was not aku employed, like she was not working. My mom is a pastor, I'm a PK. So like just her kumbeda di hello, nimeenda Ushago nipeleka fertilizer. That thing makes me feel so good. And then like analima and she harvests like a lot. And I know guess that he harvests nani anauza mahindi. Guess. Ani mwenye alitoa pesa ya fertilizer. So, like, I just love that. And I will honestly love that because I love farming. Napenda kulima sana. So, naeneza taka kwa na nyumba ya ushago.
Nyumba ya ushago.
Naweza kutakuwa na boma ushago na ya town. So that's a good expectation. Hiyo si too much for the boy child. Okay. Unajua kuna watu wamekuja invest Nairobi, they don't even care about ushago.
Bana, you have to. They don't care. Lazima tu mtendanga kutembea home. Muwezeshe ati mwende kutembelea parents.
Alafu December nataka ni wachinjiange mbuzi.
Unasikia?
Future husband, unasikia vile mipango niko nazo?
Are you getting me?
Eh, mimi nataka December niko naitia watu mbuzi kwangu na wachinjia mbuzi.
You know, unatuweka.
Si unatuweka. Nimekwambia niko ready. Niko na bio ya tailor bro. Niko na kila kitu hivi. Ni size tu tunitumia.
Ni wetu ndio tunangoja.
Mfanya
mpaka date tuko nayo.
Tuko na date. We have an ultimatum.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, the next expectation is about children. I honestly expect when we start having kids, I expect care? I expect support.
Support. Yes.
I expect support. Like honestly, bila ku complain.
Yes.
Like I expect support enye. Even if you have to complain, ongoja mpaka wa grow. Kidogo tu like a grow kidogo like afike kama 1 year. Do I sasa complain? Sasa acha nikwambie wewe mtu alikuwa ananisumbua. Like I expect full support.
It is very important.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, if you want to break your marriage, it'll break your time ya watoto.
Really?
Having a supportive partner
is
the ultimatum.
Kai.
Because that time, no, you're not working.
Yeah.
Number one. So you need someone who will take care of you, who will take care of the house, who will take care of the bills without complaining.
Yes.
Number two, your mental health is not 100%. You have insecurities.
When it is not 3%.
Uko chizi. Yani, uko moody. Kuja hata unamwangalia. Ujafanya vitu kwa nyumba. When you're pregnant, you don't even bathe every day.
Ah!
Hey!
Kwa nini, babe?
Hey! Sijui! Yani, unaweza kaa hivi uangalie maji. Ni mimi naoga. No! No!
Alive!
No thanks! Yes! Kuna discharge, kuna smelly discharge. Yani, you just have to
It's crazy.
If you don't have someone who is supporting you, imagine you'll go crazy. Ndio unapataga most people, sa zingine, most cases, mtu akizaa anapata hiyo postpartum depression.
Oh.
Kwa sababu kupata hiyo support akiwa pregnant.
Yes.
Alafu now the baby amekuja, the baby is here. Analia, you're not sleeping, your partner is not supporting you.
It's a lot.
It's a lot. You have to have a supportive
partner. A friend of mine was telling me yesterday that the importance of even having a supportive partner when kids come is because at your times the child will be crying and you're also crying.
Yes.
Why?
Guy, imagine, because unaona kwanza the first month, the kid will wake up after every 2 hours. After every 2 hours. Anaamka. Now remember the third trimester, kulala inakuwa stress. Because unaenda kulala hivi, you're not comfortable na lale. Yani, you're just not comfortable.
Yes.
So, umekuwa na sleep, ime pile up, alafu ndio kaka amekuja. After every 2 hours, nyonyo. 2 hours, nyonyo. So, imagine, you're just sleepy. The kid is crying. And your husband is telling you. And then you're sitting. Imagine.
Guy.
Yes, you have to. Hey! Hey, you have to have a supportive partner. And because I remember my husband took her two weeks paternity leave.
Oh.
He was the one cooking for me, taking care of the baby.
Did you have any other person apart from him?
Yes, but he was cooking and he alikuwa anapika.
Yes,
anaosha mtoto, ananiambia ni rest.
How do single mothers do it though? Like how do they do it? Because
kwanza unapata single mother na hiyo hata iyo pesa yako employee at a
house help. Yeah. But then unapata watu wengine, they are still in marriage, but still the partner is, you know, it's not even supportive like that.
That period you need a supportive partner and a kind partner.
Now you see, now that part scares me. That part scares me because I am a sanguine, like I'm bubbly, like I am min kerere. So imagine when my mood goes down, venye na kuanga, like najurumianga aki, and then now someone ananiambia tendeni mkalilie sitting room na mtoto.
Hey, sasa hapo utakufa. Ndio unapata watu wengine wanachukia hadi watoto.
No, yeah, serious. Na kwanza atoke kama anamfanana, alafu anakwambia mkalilie sitting room.
Alafu mkalilie huko.
Ai, 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 ai.
So you really have to have
yes, a mean, partner. Though.
Yes, amen. That's meanness. You have to have a supportive partner. That period, ikuwagi rahisi.
Yeah.
Unapata saa nyingine umeka hivi ujisikie kupika, ujisikie kufanya anything. Yani you just want to sleep the whole day.
Yeah.
Alafu mtu anakuja kuuliza, yani umeshindwa kwa hata kuna kitu yenye umefanya.
Bro, mimi naishi peke yangu na hata naweza kaa siku tatu na sijaosha nyumba.
Yes.
Na kuna kitu nafanya, I'm working from the house.
Yes.
Imagine sasa mtoto akikuja.
Imagine sasa. You really have to have a support system.
Yeah, and someone that really... But then my marriage is not a joke.
It is not. You have to put in work. Both of you.
Aya.
You have to be intentional when you get into marriage.
Yes. So, mine is not of... Yangu si expectation, rather a question. This is about spirituality. How do you deal with if you two come from different denominations? I don't, honestly, I'm a Christian. I wouldn't date a Muslim or a Hindu or an atheist. Actually, it's even easier to deal with an apana, I'm an atheist. Christian. So, but then again, tena pia kwa Christians, kuna Catholic.
Na kuna wengine wa
kuna kiroho. Sisi wengine wa kiroho. So So huyu wa kafe anakuambia yetu ndio legit.
Wa kiroho.
Yes, yetu ndio legit. Na mimi wa kiroho najua yetu ndio legit. How do you come to an agreement, because now you see the kids are already coming.
Now you have to agree.
And you have to agree, like what like how do you deal with that? Like have you experienced? Are you both? You've not experienced. I mean, what anyway?
Sisi wote ni wa kiroho. So hatujakuwa na hiyo mvutano ya nini
ya
church. Ya church.
Oh. Hey, ebu comment down below, because me I don't know.
Comment down below.
Comment down below.
Hatujakuwa na issue na hapo.
Sides, help a sister, guys. Like, how do you deal with that? Like, when your partner is Catholic and the other one is, let's say, PCA, for example, because those are two different.
They're very different.
Very different. Ah, mmoja anapewa sakramenti bila wine, bila blood, ingine anapewa kila kitu. So like, okay, that's guys, I'm trying. The example nimeona. So like, how do you deal with that? Please tell us. Okay, or tell me. Oh, because she doesn't need to know. See, wako tu sawa. Like, tell me, guys.
Comment.
Ambia, answer the word, glado.
Glado.
Iko hivi, ukiolewa na mkato. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Ivo. Another expectation. Well, mimi, kwa marriage, na expect that we will not stop dating. Like, he will not stop dating me. If we were going out, if we were going on vacations. Okay, of course, I know now you are just, you will kunarushia kuku umaindi, but ikuku ikishafika.
Ikishafika, usiache pia kuirushia tu maindi.
Please, ikuku ikishafika.
Continue dating the chicken.
Rusha sasa maindi imeiva. Rusha sasa maindi imeiva na imekarangwa. You know.
Yes, you should like, not stop dating.
Yes, I honestly.
It is very important. That's why some marriages inakuwa very boring.
Yeah.
Juu sasa bibi amekaa kwa nyumba. Kwanza sasa umeshapata mtoto au upelekwi mahali.
Imagine. And then you can imagine monotony ya kukaa kwa nyumba na mtoto.
Imagine.
Hey, bro, akia nani?
Unapelekwa
kwa baba. Hata kama ni pale South Beach kwa nataka kibandaski. Haki kuna matumbo tupa tunakula South Beach, guys. Hey, hey. Let me tell you. Matumbo ya ngapi? 30 bob na ugali.
Ugali. At least hata nakupeleka tu mahali unasikia.
Just take me somewhere, cause si kila. Like, only
yeah, at least for us, every Sunday, tunatokanga, tunaenda.
Oh,
yeah. Really? Hata kama tunaenda, hata tunaenda na tukutembea, tunaenda kuzunguka, tunaenda, tunakunywa supu. Yani, you feel, at least
time it's with something your, different. Yeah. Sato kirudi kwa nyumba, unapata mambo ikupua.
Lakini, guys. Babe, kavacation.
Kavacation, hata atutamind.
Atutamind.
But mina shindangwa, unaona kama venye saizi, like, I'm single like this. Like, utapata, for example, if like I'm dating some, like there's a person I used to date. Mzee alikuwa ananipeleka ngama vacation. Vacations. Okay, now, because we are chanad, the guy is married. And the wife is actually, okay, we're kind of friends with the wife.
Aendangi mali.
And I'm sorry, bro, why?
Shapata ngombe.
Happened what? Kerere nini? Why don't you take her out? Like, okay, let's mean expecting you, like, to kiwana.
Usiache
kufanya. And I'm not even asking for too much. I'm not asking to be taken to dates. At Maldives, you don't even need a visa. So at
una
excuse. I una excuse ya kukosa kunipeleka Maldives. Iyo si excuse. Maldives.
Hapa juu.
Maldives, you know, I even by the way, I think we're going to do Maldives is not even expensive. By the way, you want to what I'm saying, semester 6 for the world, but I know that you don't need a visa. Mm. Like most of the visa-free countries, ngana, you don't have to do visa-free countries.
Up to South Africa.
Plus, them come and me nikierere. I'll tell you what I want. Ask me, I'll tell you. Nikakupea suggestions. Nikombe by the way, even na even na even na even. You know. So I honestly don't expect him to slow down on the dating thing.
But pia uta have to understand that maybe mtapata mtoto at least isikuwe tena too much.
Si too much.
Kuna mtoto hapo wa kushukuru.
Kama mara tano kwa mwezi ni is it too much guys? mara tano kwa mwezi. Guys, it's not too much. You need too much. ama guys it's after a travel vlogger like you are a vlogger. I can manage to travel longer. Okay, by the way, Maskey, I gave him dog. I don't even like traveling. Kwanza by road. I don't like road trips. Yani unaona mwa demu fancy road trips. Me, I don't like road trips.
Fly.
Like,
what fly?
See, to fly to Fike.
Yeah, fly and Fike.
Why are we going by road?
Yes, we are. How many hours?
Why? Like, I don't get it. By the way, he doesn't.
We are sorry. I'm sorry.
See, I had a story na ati do it's a flight or anything. I don't enjoy road. See, enjoying it ati road trips at
least tunaenda na nyuki keke
ina vile mimi napenda unapenda road trips
for real
sana hata juu tunasimama Naivasha mnapiga picha
tunasimama hapo Kikope tunakula nyama
na tunaendelea
na safari
I don't like road trips imagine I think okay I don't know if I get married to someone mwenye anapenda hizo vitu I think I might naweza you don't find any
naweza kuenda naweza ruka hiyo side
yes so my other expectation would be I expect that in the long run, even before we get married, I'll expect that we have a common life plan. Unaelewa? Life goals, like tujue, like goals zenye tuko nazo zikuwe zina sink, zina. And I think that has to do also with purpose. You know, like ukisha identify purpose yako nimejua yangu, how can we be able to
merge? Twende the same direction.
Yes. So that we
actually... That's very important, by the way.
Yes.
Juu, unona couple sawe nyo unapata, in 3 years, 5 years, wame achieve a lot. Unashaka, hii may happen, aji. It's because their purpose in a line. So, ukipatana na partner mwenye, yeah, story zake ziko uko. Right. Wewe zako ziko uko. Kabla mkuja kwa line hivi.
Yes.
10 years imeshaisha. You have done nothing.
Imagine.
Umepata tu watoto.
Hiyo ni achievement pia but
lakini you have done yani nothing.
Yeah.
So lazima these things lazima muongee. Yani communication. Communication your backbone your marriage. Without communication, my friend, you have a problem.
Yeah.
You really have to talk things out. Because you have to sit as we sit at the whole night. Imagine tunaweza kaa the whole night tuongee. Na tunakuaga na book.
Oh,
tunakuanga na book yetu.
Kuandika minutes.
Yaani hiyo inakuwa ta in serious sasa.
Guy,
we have meetings.
We have family meetings. Okay, I like being serious at times, but
you have to as we have family meetings. Tunasema sawa. Hii mwaka tulikuwa tunataka ina hii. Hii tuja achieve juu ya nini? Hii what went wrong hapa hivi? Hapa alafu sasa after hapo tuna nini?
Hey, that's so beautiful.
Tunasherehekea.
That's so beautiful, guys. Guy, that is so beautiful.
Because if mnataka kwenda far na mnataka ku achieve what you want within a shorter time period sita na mkae 20 years
yeah.
Mnaanza ku achieve then mnafaa muongee tena usikwe na ule partner mwenyewe yeye anataka mkwe na TV imecha wall mzima sijui mko na nini unasahau at the end of the day mnafaa kujenga
na kama ni mjaluo. Low guys, I'm going to tap on chili.
Low guys, okay.
But I get the point.
No, Joy, you want a comfortable life at the end of the day. Yeah. So at least kujinyima hapa hizi miaka mbili tatu.
Yeah.
Alafu miaka 10 uwe na comfortable life.
It's very it's important. It's worth sacrificing.
Yes. So at least ambitions zenu zi align. Na purpose.
Okay. Yeah, so like sasa nilikuwa nasema in terms of end game. End game yetu as a couple should be the same. If we are planning to retire by God's grace, by 40 because it's possible. It's very possible. It's possible. We serve a living God. Like by 40 to me retire, sisi tuko fiti. It's very possible. Like goals zikwe, tunataka tuko tumejenga hapa.
Tumejenga hapa.
Tumefanya hivi.
Kuna hizi gari, watoto wako hizi shule.
Exactly.
Sorry, at least goals zenyu zimealign zote. Na mna work towards that purpose.
Yeah.
Si we una work towards your purpose, mina work towards my purpose.
Oh.
Yeah, alafu mna supportiana.
Yeah.
If your partner wants to go back to school, unam support. If you want to go back to school, anam support. If you want to start this kind of business, like my husband, yeah, stole his camera, I may have to learn.
For real?
Yes. I may have a kujua camera. So yeah. Sometimes at time napata job, si have kulipa mtu at 29. Tunaenda na yeye anakuwa kwa kamera 1. Pesa tunarudisha nyumbani.
Hello.
So at least unapata mtu mwenye anakusupport your career. Yaani
anakuwa is so cute.
Yaani it's the best.
Akalania ni kamera yeye anashikia mpaka kamera.
Anashika ilibidi aingie YouTube.
Tena si bende kumfunza mpaka editing utaniua.
Wow. Mimi saa zingine mimi nashoot alafu yeye ananieditia ananiambia tupe kujo. Uone kama iko sawa.
Are you serious?
Hata saa nyingine namwambia si need kuangalia wewe post nitaionea kwa
post
YouTube.
Baby.
Nitaionea kwa YouTube. So I have kujua editing, camera work, kila kitu. Na mimi sahi because yeye ni msee wa IT sana. Sahi naweza kufungulia laptop nitengeneze. Ni hunde. So at least na support anani support. Ndipo ndio tuna grow.
Pouring it with each other's cups.
Yes. Wow. Sia tia tu anani support, alafu mini kotua.
Yeah, cause mimi sasa mina kwa like, I'm the one who needs support. I'm the weaker vessel. I'm the weaker vessel. Hey, but I'm the helper. I actually should be the strongest because I'm the helper.
You're the helper. Yeah. Exactly.
Oh, wow. Hey, okay, that was amazing. Okay, zingine zimeni crash, zimeni. You know? But it is what it is. Let me ask you. Wewe before olewe, when tulikuwa single, na usidanganye because you were my friend, I knew you before you got married. What is one expectation that you had? Yenye mpaka sasa unasemanga, okay, that one I gave up, hiyo nikasema tu, for peace.
for peace.
Hata niachane nayo. What is it?
So, mimi, love language yangu ni gifts. Sana.
Okay.
So, hata tukidate, I used to gift him sana. Na yeye love language yake ni act of service.
Ah, I think for every man that's men appreciate service kupikiwa kufanywa nini
kuliko hizo vitu zingine.
Okay.
So hata nikimnunulia gift na kaje, yani alikuwa tu
it's okay. Like okay, we thank God.
It's okay. Lakini ukimfanyia something unaona imemuingia kabisa. So mimi nilikuwa najua mtu akiolewa vile kabiwa Jesus analetaga husband doesn't know things about surprises.
Yeah,
you can't tell me. Babe, I'm going to WhatsApp and I'll pick up a channel. Ni smart. Ime kufresha. Ni kununulie.
You already know it's coming.
Yes, you already know it's coming. Yeni akulelea. Close your eyes.
Close your eyes. Okay, in count of three.
Yeni kitu ilinisumbua. Alafu nikuwa najua. Akikuja home.
Yes.
After sasa nimeolewa. Akikuja home, anakulewa, anakuja na chocolate, kisho anakuja na sijui nini.
Kwa hivyo, isi nini. Anafaa kuja na kitu?
So, yani, anakuja na yo, but...
Anakuja na breakfast, too. Let me tell you guys.
Anakuja na fruits. Anakuja you are
to eat healthy.
Maybe he bought me chocolates. Ebu tukule.
Ebu leta tukule. Maybe I don't understand how. You know, Mimi, okay, me, I thank God, like, I've been raised in a complete home. Me, babangu akitoka job. Baba yangu anaingianga mashimo anakunywa anakula nyama choma before akuje home. Na afichangi anakujaka kama amewabebea. Nyinyi mnajua kabisa. Ulikuwa umekula. So like mimi I am used like nishazoea. Kujanga home. Amekuja na breakfast like mom does not need to send the house help for breakfast. Daddy anakujanga na mkate, maziwa mbili.
Sasa
na nyama.
But mimi nilikuwa najua. Utu ati ameleta chocolate, crepes, yogurt.
Yeah.
You know daily. Sasa nifika point ilibidi nimeanza ku yani kwanza story ya gifts kabla ni kuja ni accept ati hata niambia surprise.
Oh unataka drama.
Mimi nataka drama. Mimi ni wa drama.
Mimi nataka drama.
Nataka drama.
Yeah, nataka vibe. I have something for you. Akiingia hapo ananiambia babe, close your eyes. I have something for you. Anatoa surprise.
Yeah, you have suffered.
Yeah, suffered. Yani by then nilikuwa hadi nakasirika. Eh, birthday yangu nataka ni post. Sijui andike nini. Yeye tu hata ana post anaandika happy birthday my love.
A queen was born.
Mimi nataka you are very important in my life. Mm-hmm. You know, I can't live without you. Sijui nini. Yeye ataandika tu happy birthday my love bas. So yani before ni come in terms ya like who you need that he's that kind of a person.
How do you know? How does he show you love?
Yeah. Sikuzi ameanza ku learn gifts. But after observing sana.
You see, what I know is that, see, like me, what is my love language? When I think of it, touch, I think it's because I'm single, guys. It's just that bad.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if you come on, but I'm Twitter, change.
Happy, I'm gift, touch,
na time.
So, yeah, na nionyesha love through my love languages.
Oh, time. Because that's important.
Time. So every time and I get at an extra time, yes. He spends it with me.
Oh wow.
Yeah. So hata watoto tushaweka uko kwanza sisi twende. Yani he spends time with me. Yeah. He doesn't complain.
Uh-huh.
Alafu touch. My friend. Hapo hata siwezi complain.
Hapo hatuwezi sema mbona. Hapo with thank God.
Hapo with thank God.
Yeah.
Kwa hiyo tuna complain hapa bado kwa gifts.
Drama bro.
Babe. I'm a YouTuber.
Drama. Content.
Close my eyes, babe. Just
learn. It is what it is. Babe, it is what it is.
4 years, but you jalan. So learn to attend, please.
So you're guilty.
I love to say it's mimi act of service. So akipata this dream, mimi ndio nimefanya. Nimempanguzia viatu zake za job.
Yeah.
He appreciates.
Hata kienda board meeting ana command. Anambia guys, msifanye ni wambia na mebrush
pia. Oh my fun. Nasikia kuna bibi hata akiona kademu kapita hiyo ashangaza. Sasa wewe unajua bibi yangu wewe.
Have you seen my
have you seen her life?
You guys, have you seen her first of all? She's a triple B. When I was triple B, I mean, if you know, you know. B, B, B. If you know, you know.
Double package.
Kwa Mungu, kwa Yesu kuna hizi mambo. Kuna haya mambo. Unafurahia the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Yes. So, you know, expectations yenye nilikuwa nayo. But okay, bado sasa hii na hope atalan story ya gift. But as
long as he's gifting you, you know, important. It's the thought that counts. For me it's physical touch and akimimi what do I love? I don't know what I love. I think touch for me it's touch. For me it's sana it's touch. I think for me it's touch because I think it's because of course my insecurities too, like natakanga too, especially in public.
In public.
Am I really sure? Am I really sure
in public?
Asa mimi, I really love it when, like, you know, someone, you know, you hold my hand and nini, tuwa katikati ya watu, tunonge. Especially when you're with your girls and then it just comes randomly.
Grab your ass.
You know, guys, like, that thing is so good. Don't beat my nini.
You just grab it.
You know?
You grab it.
Yeah. Yeah,
you understand?
Like that. So for me, sana, top kabisa ni touch. Ni touch. But my girlfriend will say something else.
But kitu important ni, yeye learn kukupenda na love language yako, na wewe learn na love language yake. Because me, I was loving my guy wrongly, because nilikuwa nampenda na love language yangu.
Yes.
Nambaya gifts na yeye. Please, no.
But someone said, especially when the relationship is just starting, the way your girlfriend shows you love, she's just trying to communicate. Yeah, she's just trying to tell you, this is how I appreciate love. So at the end of the day, if you're a wise man, utajua
plan.
The mimi anibaya gift na mimi spendi gift. So utajua yeye, ni gift anataka. Hello, like it's a gling, 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 gling.
Beba kukwa gift. Dramatize kidogo. Apo tu dramatize tu kidogo.
Umelamba chocolate zetu zote. Zote umelamba, guys. Guys, please. Chocolate zote zimelamba hivi. They are dripping wet like this. Guys, and you are continuing.
So guys, if you have any question, if you have any comments, or if you have any concern, hapo tu kwa comment section.
Yeah.
Na kama unataka Gladys arudi tena kwa hii channel, comment hapo. She's a vibe. Atarudi tena na afungue channel yake. Ufungue channel yako by the way. I won't be hosting you every time. You have to open your own channel.
Wakati wa Mungu. Akibaji, you guys, I can sing. If I start singing here, you'll not complete this channel.
So guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for commenting. And thank you for liking this video.
Yay.
See you on the next one.
Bye-bye.